Researchers have just made a giant leap towards understanding how our human brains differ from current artificial intelligence algorithms and are now attempting to use that knowledge to develop the first artificial general intelligence. Our effort to comprehend the brain's connections is akin to extraterrestrials attempting to comprehend Earthlings. Imagine trying to trace down every single individual and their discussions across countries, reassemble chaotic fragments into intelligible communications, and deduce the entire race's zeitgeist from that data. That is, in essence, what neuroscientists want to do via brain mapping. Massive programs are vying for funding to track connections between the brain's data-crunching occupants, neurons, which are collectively referred to as the connectome. We can interpret the inner workings of the brain, which fuel our memories, thoughts, and actions, if we can listen in on those discussions. Welcome to today's episode of AI News. In this episode, I will show you how our ever-improving knowledge of the human brain can lead to artificial intelligence models quickly matching our human brain in both efficiency and generality. The concept of studying an actual human brain has sparked debate. The brain is a highly adaptable, and flexible entity. One common argument is that a connectome, any connectome, is only a snapshot in time with limited ability to represent a larger population. To naysayers, tracing a connectome is as difficult as anticipating traffic patterns by glancing at a paper map. This year, that critique was re-examined. Using an algorithm based on the connectome of one species, the lab darling roundworm C. elegans, scientists were able to predict reproductive behavior for the first time. A book-length map of another lab favorite, the fruit fly, wowed neuroscientists with fresh insights into spatial navigation, with ramifications ranging from virtual reality to robots. Huge initiatives to map our own brains, across ages and for a variety of neurological illnesses, are also in the works. Even Google has jumped on board, pledging computational resources to deal with the onslaught of data and processing demands while also looking for possible input for AI advancement. The task of mapping the brain is onerous due to its enormous complexity. The initial stage in the project was to assess the brain's hardware, the many types of neurons that make up neural processing. The second looked at where neurons branch out across brain areas to link with others, either local neighbors or far-off partners. The next step in connectomics is to focus on hard issues, rather than hardware. What can brain maps genuinely teach us about how the brain works? This is where this year's research excelled. Consider C. elegans, a tiny worm with only 302 neurons yet the only animal with a complete connectome. A team utilized the map to track the worm's mating activity in a recent research. The idea was to overlay a map of active neural networks on top of the connectome map, similar to how traffic patterns are overlaid on Google Maps. The team was able to identify a pattern that predicts mating behaviors of a ninth worm using only 8 connectomes from different worms. When a single neuron in the connectome was disrupted, the worm's mating behavior was disrupted. Dr. Vladislav Susoy, one of the study's authors, stated, "It was extremely stunning how apparent the correlation was." Fruit flies were another long-term endeavor that came to completion, no pun intended. Flies are a popular model animal in neuroscience because they are good navigators and strong warriors that are willing to tussle when confronted with an opponent. But it's still a mystery how its poppy seed-sized brain, with hundreds of thousands of neuronal branches tangled like a cotton ball, drives such activities. A researcher tracked a little piece of the fly's brain utilized for navigation this year, which is a major leap forward from C. elegans. The research scanned around 25,000 neurons and 20 million connections, yielding a wealth of information that has already sparked new hypotheses on spatial navigation. It's very exceptional. Anyone who looks at it will tell you that connectomics is a tool that we absolutely require in neuroscience. The emergence of increasingly powerful processors and ever-increasing amounts of training data has contributed significantly to AI success. The artificial neural network, however, is the principle that underpins these advancements. These networks are made up of layers of nodes that resemble neurons. A sequence of mathematical weights connect nodes in the input layer to nodes in the hidden layer, acting as synapses between neurons. A hidden layer is connected to an output layer in the same way. An array of integers might be used as input data for a job like facial recognition, describing each pixel in a face image in terms of where it falls on a scale from white to black, or whether it is red, green, or blue. Data is fed in, and the hidden layer multiplies the values by the weights of the connections to provide a response. This output is compared to what it should have been if the output were an exact match for the input, and the difference is used to alter the weights between the nodes to train the system to generate the proper response. A deep neural network, a more advanced version of this technique, includes many hidden layers. This is the type of system that DeepMind Technologies, a London-based AI research firm owned by Alphabet, used to create the computer that beat a professional human player at the game Go. A result generally heralded as a success for machine intelligence. Worms and flies may appear to be uninteresting, yet they're essential for learning about fundamental neuron activity and physiology. They also give us a sneak glimpse at what's to come. The wiring schematics of the brain, as shown in the research, are critical in assisting scientists in investigating current hypotheses and exploring new ones. Connectomes may also be easily scaled up to mice and men. The Mouse Light Project, for example, is tracing connections across the mammalian brain. With the goal of developing greater AI, Microns is creating one of the biggest roadmaps of neural connections in mice, distilling algorithms that power the cortex. We're attempting to comprehend the brain on its own terms here. This year, the Human Connectome Project, which has been ongoing for a decade, expanded brain mapping from healthy people to patients with early psychosis. They began synthesizing brain maps in people as they grew older in order to combat age-related brain problems. These are preliminary maps. Unlike animal research, the data is collected using fMRI, which has a far lower resolution than mapping individual neurons and their connections. It's far more interesting to see the forest than the trees. That may, however, be the quickest path ahead. The transition from flies to mice to humanity will necessitate a technological leap in data processing. Brains are often chopped into wafer-thin slices, chemically processed, then photographed separately under a microscope to create a connectome. Reconstructing individual photos into a brain region, or full brain, is a computational process comparable to utilizing the panorama feature on a smartphone. It's also high stakes. If one part of the brain malfunctions, the entire effort will be derailed. But there is reason to be optimistic. A Harvard-Google cooperation published a massive high-resolution image of the human brain a few months ago. Their secret sauce was to use supercomputers to automate the picture stitching process, which had previously been a major pain point. It's a great supercomputing problem, and that's what makes it intriguing. You don't want to construct a supercomputer and then leave it idle. You must seek for difficulties on the outside. New brain mapping technologies are currently being developed. TomoSEM is a technology that employs a technique similar to a CT scan to imaging a brain one slice at a time without chopping it up. Another technique, TEM, uses a special microscope to view brain slices at a far lower cost and with higher resolution. Scientists expect that, like with genome sequencing, the cost will significantly decrease when new technologies are developed, both in terms of time and money. Although they're a good start, the maps won't be adequate to decipher brain function on their own. As the fly research clearly shown, converting connections into behavior will need extensive analysis. A physical link between neurons, for example, does not always imply a functional one. It might be an unlucky fluke, similar to a Google Earth dead road. The connections in the brain are also extremely flexible, meaning they may alter with age and experience. Some argue that connectomes aren't very useful because they simply capture a snapshot. Another point of contention is which connectome should be sequenced first. Age, gender, financial background, and health may all have a significant impact on a person's brain connections. Who gets to be the common denominator for all human minds? Many aspects still need to be ironed out as the fledgling science of connectomics enters its adolescent years. What's amazing about connectomics is that, rather than waving your hand and assuming this circuit is how the brain computes, you can now see the real circuitry. Thank you for watching AI News. We consistently report on the newest technologies that are shaping the future of our world. We'd appreciate you subscribing and watching our other videos. See you around and take care.